There's no doubt about it, robots have found their way into our lives, manufacturing, healthcare, and even the food service industry. And artificial intelligence gives devices the ability to think, learn, and better interact with humans so we can coexist. But what if we need more than that? Is it possible to have a deeper connection to robots? Or even for them to value our friendship? We're about to see how one company is breaking the stereotypes of robots and using AI to do it. Presented by Mouser Electronics, Microchip Technology, Intel, Analog Devices, and Molex. This is Generation Robot. This is Vector, part of a consumer line of robots with AI that is personality-driven, designed to foster a relationship with human beings. This could transform how we interact with machines and also how they react to us. And he's designed here in San Francisco by Anki.
We think a lot about the IQ, how to make the robot smart, but also about the EQ, the emotional side of robotics. How do we bring that type of character to life and really have robot companions in the home?
Acute Exterior covers the latest in facial recognition software and AI technology. It takes the best of your smartphone, voice control device, and computer apps and adds personality. It also gets to know your habits and mannerisms in order to be a better companion.
A lot of different groups collaborate to make Vector reality. So we've got hardware team, roboticists, a whole character team, a design team, user experience teams, animation, audio. He's a little guy, but he's got a lot that goes into him.
So Vector has what you call an emotion engine.
The emotion engine is basically how Vector decides kind of how he should be feeling at any time. We have a few different moods that we're simulating at all times, and they are impacted by what's happening in his surroundings.
So you have happy, confident, social, and stimulated.
That's right. So the idea is that the stimulation level kind of tracks the amount of activity in the room.
He knows I'm here even though I'm not looking at him. The goal is to continue to expand the use of deep learning and neural nets on the robot to detect more and more things. So we're working on things like hands. People always want to know, can he see other vectors? Currently he does not, but that is the path to get there.
Hey Vector, my name is Grant. And he said my name.
People have a healthy skepticism about robotics and AI largely because of media, movies, science fiction, things like that. There are certain memes and stories that we like to tell over and over again. The scientists themselves that work in the field, when they're the ones sounding the alarm, then I think that's a good time to pay attention. As sensors get cheaper, as processing gets cheaper, you're just gonna see more and more capabilities built into robots that people can have meaningful relationships with. We're really at the cusp of a consumer robotics explosion.
When you think about robotics, it's easy to imagine jobs in manufacturing applications, service industries, and in places too dangerous or remote for us to go. But until now, robots have been working for us, to help us, with commands from us. So what does the future hold as they become smarter, independent thinkers out there on their own? We'll have to wait and see.